I'd like to start by thanking God Almighty for making this day historic. I'd like to thank him for good weather. Thank God for his love, you and me, this morning. Thank the Cardinal for inviting the Holy Spirit to take total control of this great event, historic. And let the Lord build the house of Deborah Claiborne Bay. When Dr. Professor Neighbor Michael called me from Chicago and requested that I should be part of this arrangement, this exercise, after the ambassador had spoken with me, I told him that if it had to do with humanity, you would see Nico happy. But if it had any political undertones, you would not see me. And so when they sent the package to me, and I read it, and I saw that it was clean, I decided to come aboard. And I'd like to thank those eminent professors, one of our good fathers, that my modest person, Nico Haley, should share this grand event. I am humbled. When Christ will come the second time, he is going to ask us questions after our worship to him. And those who read the Bible, I don't want to say those who read the Bible profoundly, we read the book of Matthew 25, it says that he would ask us questions like this. When I was thirsty, you didn't give me a drink. When I was hungry, you didn't give me food. When I was naked, you didn't give me clothing. When I was in prison, you didn't visit me. When I was sick, where did I see you that I did not do any of this thing to you? And the reply would be simple. We did not do this to any of the least of your brothers or my brothers. Then you didn't do it to me. Taking inspiration from that, I would like to dove my heart and congratulate those who have initiated this historic event. To cheer this great event instead of the medical officer. And I took time off my very tight schedule to get into the internet and I read about sickle cell disease. And then I checked with the experts to that here, what is all about sickle cell disease? And I got inputs. Not being a professional, I can say a few things about civil service. And yesterday evening when we had lunch at the Archbishop's supper, at the Archbishop's beautiful residence, with the Cardinal and the rest of the experts that are drawn from the world of humans, from Africa, I am so inquisitive. So I learned during that supper session. And I realized that the sickle cell disease has been destroying us. And we do not know that it really exists. And I was inquisitive, I asked the question, what is the prevalence rate of sickle cells? And they said, for some countries it's 2, some countries it's 3, some countries it's 4. And then I said, because when I read from the internet, I saw the lifespan, not more than 50, and that they have not found a cure, they can only control. But yesterday, an expert told me that it could be controlled and people would live up to about 8 years and that somebody did not push that system. So I felt really good inside me to learn that it's possible to control even though they have not found any cure for it. I'd like to say that though it has never happened in the region or in this nation that they have addressed this killer disease, this is the moment. The Lord has spoken to a few of us, our brothers in the U.S., from Mike, Neva, and his team, that they should start off, they should begin something, mustard seed here, and Northwest that is renowned for sending only negative signals, but for today we send positive signals. That's who are taking the region hostage and are systematically destroying it. This is the moment we should tell them that they don't have a right. And then we should be able to appreciate this that is happening to us because it's a social concern. It's a social concern. And so I'm humbled to be requested to chair this event. And I'd like to engage all of you, to commit all of you to be part of this success story, that at the end of it all, let glory go to God Almighty. Let glory go to one man, not to you, not to Nico Halle, not even to the experts that have come. And let us look up to heaven and say, Papa God, we thank you for this day. This is the day the Lord has made, and he has asked you and me to rejoice for it. We are here to discuss sickle cells, to get the insight of it all, but also to launch a foundation of somebody who worked indefatigably as a man of God in Bafut and in Cameroon in the person of John Kaufman. We are going to launch the foundation today, and I will call on everybody to be mobilized that foundation should come to stay and should have an impact on what we are about to put in place. Let God bless all of us, let the Holy Spirit take control of this conference that is international, and let all of us return from here accomplished and fulfilled to God's glory. I want to thank you very much, and I pray that